In our previous GoDaddy review, we took a closer look at Website Builder version 6. We aren't the only ones who weren't very happy with their product. The majority of our YouTube community wasn't either. We were wondering if GoDaddy would just increase their marketing budget or actually take some action. And indeed, they did change quite a few things. The GoDaddy girl has now been replaced by Jean-Claude Van Damme, sorry guys. The elephant hunting CEO Bob Parson has been replaced by Blake Irving, who promises to be a lot more transparent. And last but not least, GoDaddy launched version 7 of its website builder. Let's find out what the new website builder has to offer. Unfortunately, GoDaddy doesn't offer a free version like Weebly or Jimdo do. You have to pick one of their paid plans. After having registered, we see our dashboard and launch the website builder. In the control panel, we get an overview of the chosen design and some site info. If you don't like the appearance, you can switch to another theme. There's a variety of modern designs available. But take caution. Pick your theme wisely because switching to another theme involves completely losing your content, meaning you'll have to start over from scratch. Let's move on to editing our website. The new editor looks different. GoDaddy has moved the toolbar from the top to the left side. Like before, we can add new text blocks to our website via drag and drop. When we click on an element, we see more options. However, it can be quite confusing because you can't change every element as you might think. Let's try to change the color of our logo. As you can see, it doesn't work because it's a pre-formatted element. You'll need to pick another format and adapt it. Quite complicated for a simple text logo. Let's incorporate a contact form now. We click on our contact page and drag a form on our website. By clicking on it, we can change the settings. We can alter the look or change the email address of the recipient. Well done. This is pretty self-explanatory. When we're done, we save and preview our website. If we don't like it, we can undo our changes. Finally, we click on Publish. Let's head to the navigation. Click on the navigation and choose Menu. Here we can arrange the menu again via drag and drop. It's nice to see that we can build a navigation with up to 3 levels now. When you add a link, you can decide whether it's a link to an external website or an internal page. This menu is a bit confusing as you can't create a new page here. This has to be done in a similar but different menu. Unfortunately, it's not possible to secure your page with a password. This means you cannot offer exclusive or private content, which is a huge bummer. Also disappointing is the blog, which is merely a way to display the feed of an external service like Tumblr or WordPress. When you want to add a new blog post, you can't do it from within the GoDaddy website builder. Last but not least, let's check the search engine options. GoDaddy has introduced the SEO wizard, which will help beginners to optimize their content a little bit. Step by step, you add relevant information to your title, meta description, headline, and more. It's a convenient way to get your SEO homework done. GoDaddy's new website builder is definitely an improvement compared to their old clunky version. They now feature modern designs that can be edited via drag and drop, which isn't bad. It pretty much reminded us of the Wix website builder, which follows a similar user concept. However, it is much more basic than its competitor and sometimes even more complicated to handle. Many basic features like changing style site-wide, a real blog, or online store are simply missing. All in all, we saw some improvements, but there's still a lot to fix. Let's see what the future brings. In the meantime, we would definitely recommend checking out some other competing products like Weebly, Jimdo, or Wix. In case you're not sure if GoDaddy's website builder is the right choice for you, you can find a comparison chart of different providers at websitetooltester.com. And if you found this video useful, we would be very happy to receive a thumbs up and a comment. Thank you.